the game, cause see the boxing boys.
Welcome back, gang, for the first time and hopefully many more to come. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel and click on the notifications right here, this little bell, so you can get those emails every time we go live.
How would a fight with him and Callum Smith look like?
Lennox Allen, people would know Lennox Allen.
So we can definitely look out maybe Lennox Allen.
That's right. Oh, 168. That's another one. Don't fall asleep on Lennox Allen.
Now, would you put Lennox Allen, Peter Klum to kind of spar?
Oh yeah, I mean when they spar, man, those are classic sparrings.
Oh, they have sparrings.
Yeah, they have sparrings. Okay, yes. Okay. Those are classic sparrings. They go at it. I don't make them spar a lot because those kind of sparrings, I mean, they're like fights. So yeah. I mean, you don't want to use them too much. You leave that for the end, you know.
Can you explain that phrase when people say like, "Don't leave it in the gym"? You know, for people who don't know what that means.
Well, believe it or not, a lot of people, when they go in the rings and they go hard. By the time the fight comes, they have no energy or anything left because everything, they left it in the ring, you know what I'm saying? So our sparring sessions consist of, you know, being smart, a lot of legwork, a lot of, you know, not really going out there and killing yourself.
Mm-hmm. Now, sparring sessions I've heard, legendary ones, Jerome Miller, Adam Kowalski,
those guys spar, man.
Did you get to see that? Obviously.
Yeah, actually, yeah. He helped us out for, I believe, what fight was that? I think it was for the Gerald Washington fight.
Okay, okay.
So he helped us out for that camp. They had, I believe, within a month and a half, they sparred maybe 7 times. 8-10 rounds each time.
Oh my.
They were going at it.
What's a sparring session like that? The output's incredible with those
guys.
Yeah,
I mean, you're talking about each guy throwing 40, 50 punches a round.
They don't get tired?
Nah.
No?
Believe it or not. Yo, they look sluggish in there, whatever, but they don't get tired. They be throwing punches and they be placing the shots at the right place, I mean, right spots and all that. So it's a very good sparring.
Is there like, there's a misconception because, you know, TV, media have had these gladiator-like figures where they have the 8-packs, the 12-packs. You know, when you see Big Baby Miller, Babyface Adam, you know, you don't really think it until you see them, you know? Is Anthony Joshua going to be, like, in a lot of trouble when he sees these guys?
The one thing I don't want Anthony Joshua to do is overlook Big Baby. If he does that, then definitely he's going to be in trouble. Big Baby, it's like a different specimen. 315, 320 pounds that could move, that could slug, that could throw 60 punches around and doesn't get tired. He knows how to use his weight. He knows how to be dirty. He knows how to do all the other stuff. Because remember, he was in the MMA, kickboxing, yeah, and all that. So he definitely knows how to place his body with where you and I used to seeing bodies and all that. So he definitely knows how to weigh you down, where to touch you so you can get your thigh hurting or, and you know, all that stuff. He knows all that. So, I mean, if Anthony Joshua is overlooking, don't, because then you'll be in trouble.
Now, with Adam, because you saw the sparring session with Jarrell, people have been linking him maybe in the future to fight Deontay Wilder. How would a fight maybe with Adam Kowalski and Deontay Wilder look like?
Wow, remember, but Wilder and Joshua are two different things. I mean, the thing with Wilder has a different, he got the equalizer. That's the only difference. I mean, but as far as like boxing skills and all that, I mean, Wilder is a little less than Joshua. Joshua is a very smart boxer, you know what I'm saying? But he don't have the equalizer. He will have to get you maybe with 3-4 shots before, you know, anything happens. But with Adam, if that fight happens, I think Adam is definitely going to have to improve his defense, because sometimes he does go in there a little careless and get hit with too many shots. And with Wilder, you just can't afford to get hit with shots like that, you know?
Awesome. Well, look, I appreciate you giving me the time to interview you. Social media for your fans, where to follow you and your journey.
Instagram, Social Crew Talk.
Awesome. Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Hit the like, subscribe, and share. As always, if you want to support us to the next level, head over to the patreon.com/theboxingvoice. We have tons of exclusive from Border Wars and Title, betting shows, the list goes on and on and on. But in addition to that, if you guys have questions for fighters, trainers, or promoters, this is where you can submit them. We will run out, get these questions answered and put it back on the show just for you guys. Appreciate it.
Peace.